أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. فاذكروني أذكركم واشكروا لي ولا تكفرون. يا أيها الذين آمنوا استعينوا بالصبر والصلاة إن الله مع الصابرين. إن الله مع الصابرين. ولا تقولوا لمن يقتل في سبيل الله أموات الأحياء تشعرون. ولنبلونكم بشيء من الخوف والجوع ونقص من الأموال والأنفس والثمرات وبشر الصابرين. صدق الله العظيم.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تتخذوا عدوي وعدوكم أولياء تلقون إليهم بالمودة إلى آخره. Yesterday we completed 59 verses, 59 surah chapter of the Quran Kareem, and there are total 114 chapter of the Quran, and we have only 2 days. Surah Al-Mumtahina is a Madani surah, 13 verses, and the Mumtahina means the woman to be examined. The theme of this surah is boycott to non-Muslims who fight against you, and be kind and deal justly to non-Muslim who are not fighting against you, who are not raising arms, and who have not drive you out from your homes. And next is Surah Al-Saff, Madani surah, 14 verses, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الَّذِينَ يُقَاتِلُونَ فِي سَبِيلِهِ صَفًّا كَأَنَّهُمْ بُنْيَانٌ مَرْسُوسٌ. Allah likes those who fight in the rows as a solid structure for the way, in the way of Allah, and to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Surah Al-Jumu'ah is a surah in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, when you hear azan, come to offer the Jummah prayer. After the completion, seek the bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Means whatever you are doing, job, business, you should involve yourself and you should seek Allah's bounty. So getting risk provision and struggle for the business, for job, this is also the bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Surah Al-Munafiqun tells us, the good appearance doesn't mean the good behavior. Munafiqun, munafiq, hypocrites. They used to sit with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to learn deen from him, but at the same time they had in their hearts bad feeling about Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, about the believers, about the religion. So that is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says their looks doesn't mean what they have in their hearts. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala indicate the believers to avoid them and to understand them. And next surah is Surah At-Taghamun, that emphasize to prepare yourself for the day of judgment. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Aulad, childrens, and wealth, they are the favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But at the same time, they are the test for the man, whether they look after them, or they are eager for them, or they, and the person, the man, looks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in case children and wealth requires to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he should not go to children and to the wealth, and he should obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Next surah is Surah At-Talaq. Surah At-Talaq, talaq means divorce, and divorce, as you are aware, creates differences in social life. To avoid it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided us to observe the rulings and instruction that is given in this surah, in so that you should avoid the social differences in the society. And talaq is one of the things that is allowed, but it is not liked by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Surah At-Tahrim, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, no one has authority to make the things halal or haram. It is only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who can make things halal or haram. And Surah At-Tahrim also guides us to protect. Allah says, you protect yourself and the family from the hellfire through good trainings and education. Some people, sometimes they say, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala do our children best, but they forget the training to the children is our responsibility, not the responsibility of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addresses to men, ya ayyuha, and to believers, ya ayyuhalladhina amanu qu anfusakum wa ahlikum nara. Next surah is Suratul Mulk, and in Suratul Mulk, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to recite this surah every night. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, anyone who recites the 30 verses of this surah will intercede in the day of judgment to one who recite it in this word. And this is very important surah, subject and topic wise. And this is also the praising to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, tabarakalladhi biyadihil mulk wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadeer. Next surah is Suratul Qalam. Suratul Qalam, Qalam means pen, and Suratul Qalam tells us Allah's messenger is on the highest standard of character, and whatever he speaks, whatever he does, it is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as qalams transfer the ink, whatever it, the color is in the pen, whatever is in the pen, it qalam transfer to the paper. And the same thing, whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives to his messenger, and his messenger Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam transfer to the ummah, to human being. So you have to follow. And Suratul Qalam also tells us, whatever you spend in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you will get back from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Next surah is Suratul Haqqa and Ma'arij. Both surah are the picture of the day of judgment, and very important surah. And most of the surah now, they are related to the creed of the Qiyamah, because the Mushrikeen in Makkah, the people who lives in Makkah, they associate with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they didn't believe that they will be alive after death. So they don't believe, they didn't believe life after death. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replied them, Allah has the power to create the man, Allah has the power to raise the man after his death. And next surah is Surah Nuh. And Surah Nuh is very important surah for those who are doing the work of the da'wah, invitation towards Islam. That gives us the techniques of the da'wah. in the light of Hazrat Nu Ali Salatu Wasalam work. Hazrat Nu Ali Salatu Wasalam work day and night, and he invited the people in the public and secretly, and he invited the people in a different way. All the techniques is mentioned here, and other things that in this surah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned. If you seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will shower his blessing upon you. So seeking forgiveness, istighfar, is cause the increasing the wealth, increasing the risk, and cause Allah's blessing and the mercy, and cause having the children from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The next surah is Suratul Jinn. Suratul Jinn indicates that Allah can help his religion through jinn. If you are not obeying, if you are not following Allah's commandment, then Allah can take the help of the religion by the jinn. And because he has the power over jinn and over human being, over whole universe. And Rasul, in fact, this surah indicates when Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam recited Quran Kareem while he was coming back from the Taif, then some group of the jinn, they heard the Quran, and they, after hearing the Quran, they came into Islam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala indicated to his Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you are the prophet of human being as well as you are the prophet of the jinn. And next surah is Surah Muzzammil and Surah Muddassir. Surah Muzzammil and Muddassir, both surah revealed in the beginning of the Makkah period, when Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam received the first revelation, Iqra bismi rabbika alladhi khalaq, in the cave of Hira. And laterly there was some time that the revelation could not come by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed these verses and these surah, Ya Ayyuhal Muddassir, Ya Ayyuhal Muzzammil, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked to his Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to stand and to invite your relatives and your friends towards Islam. The next surah is Suratul Qiyamah, that also present the picture of the day of judgment. And other surah is Surah Insan, and another name is Surah Dahar. The importance of this surah is Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to recite this surah on Friday in the Fajr prayer. Surah Insan and Surah Sajda. Surah Sajda in the first rak'ah and Surah Insan in the second rak'ah. Inshallah, tomorrow we will start Surah Mursilat until Suratul Nas. And Surah Mursilat is an important surah that Rasulullah recited in his last prayer that he led to the community, to the Muslim Ummah. And Rasulullah led the last prayer, Maghrib prayer, in which Rasulullah recited Surah Mursilat. وَمَا عَلَيْنَا إِلَّا الْبَلَاغُ الْمُبِينَ.
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم عليه. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وأدخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار يا عزيز يا غفار يا رب العالمين. اللہ ہماری یا اللہ دنیا اور آخرت دونوں کی بلائیاں نصیب فرما. اے اللہ ہماری زندگی جو غفلت میں گزرتی جا رہی ہے, اللہ تو ہمیں ایمان کی کلمے کا یقین نصیب فرما. محمد صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم سے اور نبی علیہ الصلوۃ والسلام کی سنتوں سے ہمیں محبت نصیب فرما. اللہ ہماری زندگی کا ایک ایک لمحہ قیمتی ہو جائے. اللہ اپنی نافرمانی سے ہمیں یا اللہ تو بچا لے. یا اللہ ہماری دستگیری فرما, ہماری رابری فرما. اللہ رمضان مبارک کا جو مہینہ ہے اس کا ایک ایک لمحہ یا اللہ ہم آپ کی اطاعت کرے. اپنی نافرمانی سے اللہ تو ہماری حفاظت فرما. اللہ دائیں سے بائیں سے اوپر سے نیچے سے آگے سے پیچھے سے طرفین سے طرفین سے یا اللہ جو شیطان ہر وقت حملے کر رہے ہیں اللہ سوتے ہماری حفاظت فرما. نفس اور شیطان دونوں کی شرور سے اللہ ہماری حفاظت فرما. اپنی رضا والے اعمال نصیب فرما. اللہ قبر کے جانے سے پہلے پہلے قبر کی تیاری کی توفیق عطا فرما. اللہ ہم سارے مسلمانوں کو آپس میں محبت نصیب فرما. اللہ یا اللہ ہماری دستگیری رہبری فرما. اللہ جو ہم سے پہلے دنیا سے چلے گئے, اے اللہ ان کی مغفرت فرما اور ہمیں قبر کی تیاری کی توفیق عطا فرما.